By the way, remember I talked at length about the need to continue to invest in research and development. Look what's going on from the Department of Energy in the nuclear front. There's a lot of good news on the horizon.
The good news is amazing news. The president is talking about a possibly world-changing scientific breakthrough at Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory in California, where scientists for the first time ever created a nuclear fusion reaction that generated more energy than it took to trigger the reaction, creating a net energy gain with zero carbon emissions. Our next guest, physicist Annie Kritcher, one of the scientists who worked on the project, called the achievement one of the most significant scientific challenges ever tackled by humanity.
So the ultimate goal, as Alex mentioned, is to create a design that can reach the extreme conditions required for fusion ignition on a NIF. And in doing so, we were able to reach pressures more than two times the center of the sun on the last experiment and about 150 million degrees.
Joining us now is Andrea Kritcher, a physicist with the Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory. She is the principal designer for this breakthrough experiment. Thank you very much for joining us tonight. I didn't dare take physics in high school, so could you please explain this so that even an anchorman has a chance of understanding it?
Sure. So what we're doing here is combining two light nuclei so that when they undergo a nuclear reaction, that releases energy. And the way that we do this is we essentially have to create a miniature star in the laboratory with giant lasers. So what we do is we shine the giant lasers onto the inside of a gold can or cylinder about the size of the top of a pencil eraser. We create a hot X-ray bath inside of that cylinder. It's about 3 million degrees X-ray bath. That explodes the outside of a BB-sized capsule, which holds the fusion fuel. This accelerates the fusion fuel inwardly in an implosion, so it's a rocket-like effect. And then we can get to the right pressures and temperatures from that inward acceleration or implosion. As I mentioned earlier, more than two times the center of the sun and 150 million degrees.
So
I hope that was clear.
I'm gonna do my anchorman nod where I pretend I understood that. But so we have a possible energy source here in the future. Is this feeling something like the 1860s in Pennsylvania when oil was first discovered in the earth? And, you know, cut to a century later, that oil is flying planes around the world and motoring pretty much everything that we move in?
You know, that's pretty much exactly what it feels like to me. And that's a great analogy. I think ignition is the first crucial step in getting a clean fusion energy future. Here we demonstrated that that's possible for the first time on the NIF. There's a lot of work to get to the final step where we're powering people's homes. Quite a bit of development, technology development needs to happen, design development, laser development. But, you know, this is just the start of something really awesome, and I'm super excited.
So do you believe that during your lifetime you will see the practical application of this?
I think it's a good possibility for that. So in the director's speech, she sort of mentioned decades, not five decades. And so I do hope that it's closer to the couple of decades timescale. And with a lot of people, with enough people and enough passion and enough investment, good things can happen fast.
Have you felt that you haven't had enough support to get as far as you've gotten so far?
I think that we have a lot of very passionate people that are determined and have worked really hard to get to where we are. We have ideas for how to increase that and push it in the future. There's quite a bit of interest and support from academia and all the national labs working together. The private sector is now becoming a major player. So all of these things working together, we're going to see more movement than we've than we've seen in the past. It'll be a faster paced movement. And I do think that we had enough support to get to where we are, because here we are. And I see that support growing now more than ever.
Andrea Kritcher, congratulations on this incredible breakthrough and giving us all the promise of a brighter future. Thank you very much for joining us tonight.
Thank you.